Christ is nigh, he seems to say, cast away the dreams of darkness, O ye children of the day. Fatal death, a solemn warning, let the earth-bound soul arise. Christ, our Son, was Lord, his belly shines upon the morning skies.
The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We say the collect for purity together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Good morning and welcome, my brothers and sisters, to our Sunday worship. Today is the very first day of new church year. This is the beginning of the year A, which is the year of Matthew. Therefore, as you can see, we have the beautiful Advent wreath with Advent candles. We're going to soon bless this wreath, and we're going to light our very first candle together. And then this is a wonderful season because it helps us to actually reflect on the meaning of Christmas more. And I would love to encourage you to spend some time during this season of Advent so that you may be able to have some connection with our Lord who has come, who came to us as one of us. So we are going to use a slightly different style of the liturgy during the season of Advent. The normal, the prayer of the penitents, we are not going to use it, but we're going to use a bit more simplified version of the sorry prayer. So you will need to be called, you will need to say is the Lord have mercy part. You will find out. And then also during the season of Advent, as I said earlier, we are going to omit the Gloria, as we do in the season of Lent, waiting for the moment when we can enjoy the glorious singing the glorious song together. So, at the beginning of this the season of Advent, I'm going to ask the server to come here. We're going to bless this Advent wreath. And then later, if you just go down and then bring the candle light there, that will be much appreciated once we bless that. Okay, we're going to bless this Advent wreath first. Let us pray. O God, by whose word all things are sanctified, Pour forth thy blessing upon this wreath, and grant that we who use it may prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ, and may receive from thee the abundance graces. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Stand. There's a blue light. Go to candle stand. Yes. No, candle stand.
Oh.
Yeah. Thank you. O Lord, stir up thy might, we beg thee, and come, that by thy protection we may deserve to be rescued from the threatening dangers of our sins and saved by thy deliverance. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O Heavenly Father, you have created a universe of light. Forgive us when we return to darkness. Lord, have mercy. Lord. Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Cleanse and heal our blinded sight. Christ, have mercy. O Holy Spirit, you give us light in our hearts. Renew us in faith and love. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive us our sins and open our eyes to God's truth. Strengthen us to do God's will and give us the joy of his kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son Jesus Christ came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now, please be seated for the scripture reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The word that Isaiah, son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains and shall be raised above the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that we may teach us his ways and that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth instruction and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and shall arbitrate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And in response to the psalm, "I was glad when they said to me, 'Let us go to God's house.' I was glad when they said to me, let us go to God's house. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to God's house. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love you. Peace be within your walls and quietness within your towers. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to God's house. For my family and companion's sake, I pray for your prosperity. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek to do you good. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to God's house.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Now, if you can, would you please stand up for the gospel reading?
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. And hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus spoke to his disciples. About that day and hour, no one knows, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. For as the days of Noah were, so will be the coming of the Son of Man. For as in those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day Noah entered the ark. And they knew nothing until the flood came and swept them all away. So too will be the coming of the Son of Man. Then two will be in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Two women will be grinding meal together, one will be taken and one will be left. Keep awake, therefore, for you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. But understand this, if the owner of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and would not have let his house be broken into. Therefore, you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now please be seated. Now, I have to say that I feel much, much better. Before the service begins, my mind is like that. Do you know what I'm talking about? One particular day when you come to the church, sometimes you feel, yes, I'm ready to worship the Lord. I'm ready for a prayer. But sometimes when you come to the church, you carry all the issues, all the things that you... Do you see what I mean? Your brain is always packed with something. And then this morning, although it is important Sunday and wonderful Sunday in a way, I have to make confession to you now, my heart was fully occupied with other things. It is not non-Christian things I was being occupied, but it was all church-related things. But sometimes this daily, the duties, have I prepared everything? Is everything right in place? And then I just, before the service began, after the 8:30 service, I remembered one important thing which I completely forgot. And then if I had remembered, I could actually ask some, church wardens to help me, but I forgot that. And then I had to just do something half panicky mode. I did it, but, do you see what I mean? And then I just heard the urn is not working. I saw the church wardens running around to resolve the issue. Well, finally, the urn is working. That means we're going to have tea and coffee after the service. That's good. That's good. And then before the service begins, we had a very strange visitors as well, quite unusual. We don't see him very often. But do you see what I mean? One of those days that our mind is occupied by so many things, So at the end, it was so hard for me to focus on even what I was saying. I want you to know I'm also the human being. So sometimes, at the beginning of the service, if you remember, oh, Father Tim, what did you do? It is written there in the book, but I don't think I can now remember what I said. So I ask the forgiveness of the Lord because I was not ready spiritually. So I have to make that comment now at the beginning of the service. But good Lord is always good. Lord is good. And while I was sitting there listening some readings and I'm doing some psalms, I just remember, the Lord gave me this kind of thing. That's the life. It's okay for me to be in that kind of panicky situation as long as I remember one thing. In the middle of the chaotic life, not only me, of us, of human beings, suddenly, without making too big announcement, our Lord was born as one of us. Without me noticing, the whole story of salvation has begun in a small town in Israel. When we're busy, you don't even feel that you are hungry. When you really drawn into certain things, you don't have any energy to look around. You just focus on what you have to do. Sometimes you devalue everything. But interestingly, while we are thinking about earthly things, quietly, quietly and secretly, God sent his own Son to us so that those who hope in him may have eternal life. I think at the end of the day, what we share in this season of Advent, what we proclaim day by day, week by week, is the message of salvation, message of God's generosity, a message of love of our Lord towards us. With that love, we are here to worship the Lord. And then as long as we remember that love from God towards us, I truly believe, even if we have no coffee nor tea, it wouldn't be a big issue, because we are here to share that love which will make us warm in our heart, which will give us strength in every single day. And it will help us to renew our faith daily and every second. The reason why I mentioned to you that I was not focusing at the beginning is to show you that we are all human beings. The important thing, I believe, what we are called to do, is to realize the issue that we have. And when we change our mind, when we acknowledge that fault, and when we say to God, even if with that short seconds, 1 or 2 seconds, oh God, I'm sorry, oh, help me, then the Lord will respond to your prayer. Season of Advent, I believe, is a special season that we can use so that we can maximize the joy of season of Christmas. Therefore, I'd love to suggest you, each and every one of you here in this church, also those who are following us online, to focus on the message each Sunday. And if you're not sort of the person who will spend more time in reflections, it's fine, that's fine. But try to spend only a couple of minutes to think about the message that you heard on Sunday. This week, we heard a message of peace, that our Lord will come to us without being noticed. But the promise that we receive from our Lord is a message of peace. Prince of Peace, that is his name. So, as the beginning of this new Christian year, the year of Matthew, our first Advent candle is lit now. So, dear my friends, let us focus on the message that we all know. Let us go back to the basic, bringing our sins, repentance. The Lord will forgive, will be drawn into his presence, and by his promise, we will all go to heaven when he shall come to us to judge the living and the dead. So at the end, the Christian life on earth is all about hope. Hope for the future. Hope for the kingdom. Hope for the eternal life. So may God bless each and every one of us, and as St. George's Church, as a Christian church, in this season of Advent. So whatever happens, we may just draw into, you see me running around, you see church wardens running around, you see PCC members running around, it looks like we're just running around, just being busy for the sake of being busy. But still, let us keep the message of Christ in the heart of our community here in the church. May God bless each and every one of us in this wonderful season of Advent. May the light of our Lord be shine around. Amen. And now, dear my friends, before we offer some prayers of intercessions, it's a time for us to offer the statement of our faith. That's the Nicene Creed. If you can, Would you all please stand to say the creed together? We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. He became incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now, please be seated as we offer some prayers of intercessions.
Almighty God, on this Advent Sunday, we give thanks for the first glimmers of the light, which reminds us of the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ. We believe that your light has power to overcome all darkness, and pray that through this season of Advent, we may share in the mystery of your coming into the world. We pray for the Church today, gathering worldwide in various places of worship to praise and hear your holy word. Give us a sense of expectation as we come and inspiration as we go. We pray for your blessing on those who lead, especially Father Taman here in our parish, as he will guide us on our spiritual journey through Advent, until we celebrate together the birth of your Son on Christmas Day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Creator God, today our prayers for this troubled world are for a solution to war and conflict. Govern the hearts and minds of all world leaders and those in authority, that they may act justly, honestly, and according to your will. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our families, friends, and for those who live in our community. Protect and guide them day by day as they look to you in faith for all their needs. Help us all to try and set an example of a true sense of preparation in this Advent season, so that we can all together experience the true meaning of Christmas. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful God, we pray for all those for whom this day will be long and painful, for those in hospital or ill at home, those struggling with despair or depression, and for all who care for them. In a moment of silence, please pray for those on your mind at this time. We also remember, especially today, Michael Shine, Barbara Baker, Derek Rich, Russell Trotman, Malachi Reed Gray, Alfie Springle, Paul Alfonso, Cliff Ray, Cameron Che Williams, Paula Beckwith, Sue Spice, Althea George. Comfort and heal all who suffer. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for those who have died recently or at this time of year. Be near to all who mourn and comfort them with the knowledge that in the coming of our Son, Jesus, the gates of heaven have been opened wide for all who accept him as Lord and Saviour. Recently, we remember the lives of Lawrence Ferdinand, John Foster, Violet Pockrank, and those whose anniversaries occur this week: Georgina Constable, Terence Franklin, Victoria Evans, Joan Beasley, Emily White, Edward Hoy, George Hobbs, William Curnow, Lily Hunt, Charles McCraw, Paul Burnicle, Harry Darlow, Arthur Bowen, Annie State, Gladys Street, Dennis Parrott, Martha Robinson, Albert Lamb, Ronville Sleet, Frederick Threadgold, Frederick Batkins, and William Fifield. May the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Holy God, during this season of Advent, as we move towards the festivities of Christmas, we pray that peace will flow from all our actions this week. Rejoicing in the fellowship of St. George and all your saints, we commend ourselves and the whole creation to your unfailing love. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. If you can't, would you please stand? In the tender mercy of our God, the dayspring from on high shall break upon us to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Now let us offer one another the sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Thank you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks because you sent him to redeem us from sin and death and make us inherit us of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may with joy behold his appearing and in confidence may stand before him. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, the apostles, the martyrs, Saint George, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord.
By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Body of Christ.
body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Thank you.
will set us free. Leaving, Lord Jesus, help us see you are Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, I would come to you, leave my life for you, Son of God. All your commands I know are true, your many gifts will make me new. Into my life your power breaks through.
Let us pray. Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord, that when he shall appear, he may not find us sleeping in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we also say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Good morning, welcome everyone on this bit drizzly day today. Yes, the urn is a bit up and down, Joan, just to warn you, but it has been boiling, so hopefully, but the kettles are there just in case. So yes, please join us for tea and coffee afterwards. The extra, those who are part of it, we have our 100 Club draw for November, so please join us for that. The box at the back is there for those who are able to help with presents for the children in the local area. Going to St John's Evangelist for their collection, Palmer's Green. The details are on your service sheet. So it will be there until Sunday the 18th of December and then delivered before Christmas. So anything you can help with will be very much appreciated. As I say, the info is on the pew sheet. And there's a couple of other things on the pew sheet. Read your notes. Enfield in Song Choir on the 16th of December. And, the Mothers Union AGM, which is this Tuesday. The details are there. Now, yesterday, 21 of us... I'll explain in a minute. 21 of us went to the Advent service at St Paul's Cathedral. And because of the train strike, we had to adjust our travel arrangements. So we all met at Oakwood Station and then on the Piccadilly line via a couple of stops, Holborn to St Paul's. And of course there were 21 of us, all different ages, which was fantastic. I thought, well, I've got to be like one of those travel people with the umbrella. So I took a St George flag with us. So anyone could see me, which is not always the good thing. So I kept that on the tube station, especially when we were changing trains. So I thought I'd bring it to Smalling to jog those memory. And then, of course, I used to wave it. And, when I went to St Paul's, we got in the queue because we had tickets, but I wasn't allowed to take this in. It was taken away by the security at St Paul's Cafe. I said, I'm a church warden, you know. But, no, they took it away. And luckily enough, it was still in the box when I came out, so I was able to get it back for the journey home. Now, very quickly, the journey home. because the line we were on, something happened, we had to get a bus. And that was because everyone else was getting a bus. It was sardine times. So we, eventually got to Holborn and got on the tube, and then we got to Arnos Grove. We had to get off the train, and but we all got home, hopefully, safely. But it was a lovely service. Lovely choir. We sung a lot of carols. Even the Bishop of London was there. So it was lovely to see so many from our church, and thanks for coming. And now I would like to just hand over to Rebecca, because next Saturday is our Christmas market. So, yes, here we go.
Morning, everyone. So, as you know, our Christmas market is next Saturday. So thanks to everyone that's donated and helping to run a stall. The hall is full. We can't have any more stalls because there's no room, which is amazing. Please make sure you brought your raffle tickets. Some of the prizes are at the back of the church, so you can see what you're winning. There is more prizes to follow as well. If you are running a stall, the hall will be open on Friday night from 7 p.m. if you need to set up, and then on the Saturday from 9 a.m. I will be there from 9. If you could wear your Christmas jumpers, Christmas hats, so we can make it as festive as possible. We want to spread the word as much as possible, so we're putting up a new banner this morning that's going on the front of the church hall. And also, we want to put slips through people's doors to make them aware that we've got our Christmas market on. So some of them have already gone for some roads, but if you can see me after the service, if you can put some slips through people's doors during the week, that'd be great. And also, please bring your friends and family along. The more the merrier. Thank you.
Yesterday, I heard the journey home was quite dramatic, and then I was sitting there, and then I thought, what if I called it Journey Home from Hell? But that means that will make St. Paul's as a hell, so no, that's not the right expression. But I have to say a big thank you, and well done, every one of you. And then it was really funny, because when I joined you guys, because I went to Westminster Abbey to see my son, to say happy birthday to him. And then I joined the St. Paul, not for the service, to say hello to everybody. But the day was sharing that flag, because he's tall, not short. And I could see his flag. And then that was just so funny. And then when we get together in front of the north door, yeah, we usually get together, we said, we even did a very short live streaming. Everybody who were passing there was looked at me, what is he doing? What is he doing like that? But we had a great fun. But I think, and I have to say a big thank you for each and every one of us, especially for the those who organized it, Dave and Jenna, thank you. And then that's not easy. Whenever we go for somewhere as a group, please expect some unexpected things may happen, okay? That's a drama, and that is a part of joy of we do something together. So if there's ups and downs, just laugh, smile, and carry on. And also, I want to ask especially all of you, this is completely different from Advent things, Christmas. I think it's a D-27, today or something, but I have to ask you to remember this. We are now going into the really busy time, busy season. Well, Christmas market is set today, and then busy Christmas, Christingle makings. Do you know what I'm talking about? We're going to be really busy, but let us slow down. Yeah? Even if we have 10 or 20 Christingles shorter than what we have planned, it is not going to change the whole world. Whenever we do the Remembrance Sunday, I always want to be there at 11 o'clock, but it's impossible. You see what I mean? But whenever I say, oh, I was a little bit late, I was too early, scout leaders always come to me and say, oh, Father, tell me, don't worry. I'm not worrying, but they say, important thing is for us to do the act. Yeah? For Christmas, important thing is for us to enjoy ourselves. So I have to completely be honest. I am seriously worrying about our church wardens and their families. Don't overwork. If you think you're going too much, just let me know and then stop. We are fine. We will understand that. And also, the church warden's busy, so I'd love to encourage each and every one of you to support them as much as I can, because we work together as a team. Someone must take a lead, and thankfully we do have very good church wardens and PCC members who are also active in actions. So we are lucky, so let us help them as much as we can. And then if there is any mistakes, you know me. We laugh and we just carry on. At the end of the day, the God is coming to us, and no one can change the day of Christmas, 25th of December. Okay? Let's relax. And that is one last thing that I wanted to say to you. Brilliant. There is another thing that I need to say. That is a Christmas Day. We don't have any 8:30 service, only 10 o'clock service. And also the New Year's Day, we are not going to have 8:30 service, only 10 o'clock service. That's something that I am going to put on the pew sheet in the future. Other than that, I hope you enjoy the rest of the day. And if you ended up drinking kind of lukewarm and then ice cold tea or the ice cold coffee, we are not going to complain. Okay? Brilliant. Would you all please stand for the final blessing? The Lord be with you. Christ, who has nourished us with himself, the living bread, make you one in praise and love, and raise you up at the last day. And the blessing of God the Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Now the mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. Now we're going to sing our final hymn, hymn number 293.
Hide it, nothing cares.